Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
You're probably wondering who I am. I'm Keith Scott. I'm retired and I live in Armagh. Most of you will have not come across me before. I've never been in this group of parishes before. So your luck has just run out. Yes, I have a few announcements to make. First of all, services next Sunday, November the 5th, they'll all be morning prayer too, and will be conducted by Mrs. Maureen Levy. Then the annual hospice Sunday appeal. There are envelopes available to collect from church today. Are they hanging about the church porch or somewhere like that? They'll be out there somewhere. So lift them, take them away, and stick something in them. And if you have, if you're able to gift aid the donation, then please fill out a form at the back of the envelope. If you're seeking something in a country like me, I once went, came into church one time, and I offered the whole congregation, I said, I have got two notes here. One of them is a dollar note, and one of them is a $10 million note. And it was a $10 million note with Zim dollars. They bought you a crust of bread. Safeguarding training has been organised on Monday the 30th of October via Zoom, 7:30 p.m. to 10:30 p.m. This training is open to all those who are working with young people in our churches. If you have any queries, please contact Mrs. Karen Marshall in Thailand. I imagine you'll need to contact her if you want the Zoom link for the meeting. So do have a go at that. Zoom is a wonderful thing these days. It's everybody in contact. Skype, Zoom, WhatsApp. It's amazing. I lived overseas for 10 years, off and on. And back in the old days, when we first went out, we were still kind of on dial-up email services. And you still have to, there's all a bit pick and miss as to whether you got your email or not. Depending on what the phone lines were doing up there, all kind of move over in. And, you know, the days before that, Christmas, you know, I've got a Christmas card, not the following Easter, but the Easter after that. Anyway, that's all the announcements that I can make. Our service, I believe, is Holy Communion Rite 1. We're going to start singing a hymn.
Who put that there?
Who put that floor there? Hymn number 537. Hymn number 537. Yes, that's what I'm told. I'm reliably informed.
Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us
our trespasses,
those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts be open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord. Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ said. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like unto it. Thou shalt love thy neighbour as thyself. On these two commandments depend all the law and the prophets.
Lord,
Lord, Let us pray. The collect for today, 21st Sunday after Trinity, the last Sunday after Trinity. Blessed Lord, who caused all holy scriptures to be written for our learning, help us to hear them, to read, mark, learn, and inwardly digest them, that through patience and the comfort of your holy word, we may embrace and forever hold fast the blessed hope of everlasting life, which you have given us in our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. The epistle this morning is written in the epistle of St. Paul, the apostle to the Thessalonians, the first epistle of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Chapter 2, beginning at verse 1. For you yourselves know, brethren, that our visit to you was not in vain, but though we had already suffered and been shamefully treated at Philippi, as you know, we had courage in our God in the face of great opposition. For our appeal does not spring from error or uncleanness, nor is it made with guile. But just as we have been approved by God to be entrusted with the gospel, so we speak, not to please men, but to please God who tests our heart. For we have never used either words of flattery, as you know, or a cloak for greed, as God is a witness. Nor did we seek glory from men, whether from you or from others, though we might have made demands as apostles of Christ. We were gentle among you, like a nurse taking care of her children. So, being affectionately desirous of you, we were ready to share with you not only the gospel of God, but our own selves, because you have become very dear to us. This is the word of the Lord. Now we have our psalm this morning. Our psalm is Psalm 90. Psalm 90. We're going to stand and say it by alternate half verses. Psalm 90, it's on page 697. And we're going to say verses 1, 2, 1 to 6, and 13 to 17. Psalm 90 on page 697. Verses 1 to 6 and 13 to 17, we're going to say that by alternate half verses. Lord, you have been our refuge. Before the mountains were brought forth, all the earth and the world were formed. You turn us back to dust and say, a thousand years in your sight are as yesterday. You sweep them away like a dream. In the morning it is green and flourishes. Turn again, O Lord, how long will you delay? Satisfy us with your loving kindness in the morning. Give us gladness for the days you have afflicted us. Show your servants your works. May the gracious favor of the Lord be upon us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Please be seated for the second reading. Oh, sorry, we stand. I beg your pardon. We stand for the Gospel. Isn't that the good news of our Lord Jesus Christ, as proclaimed according to St. Matthew? Chapter 22, beginning at verse 34. When the Pharisees heard that Jesus had silenced the Sadducees, they came together, and one of them, a lawyer, asked him a question to test him. Teacher, which is the great commandment in the law? And Jesus said to him, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. This is the great and first commandment. The second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments depend all the law and the prophets. Now, while the Pharisees were gathered together, Jesus asked them a question, saying, what do you think of Christ? Whose son is he? And they said, the son of David. He said to them, how is it then that David, inspired by the Spirit, calls him Lord, saying, the Lord said to my Lord, sit at my right hand till I put thy enemies under thy feet. If David thus calls him Lord, how is he his son? And no one was able to answer him a word, nor from that day did anyone dare to ask him any more questions. This is the Gospel of Christ. Please be seated.
Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
I don't know where they put the sermon anymore these days in services. You keep moving these things around, and being away overseas for some years, you come back and you find everything has changed since you went away. I went away in 2002, and when I arrived back 6 years later, I discovered they even introduced a whole new prayer book. And I'm still trying to find my way around it. Even though I kind of was using it for a few years in Limerick. So it's a bit, don't follow me, I'm lost too. That was sort of in human existence, one of the big driving forces for human beings. Is a sort of competition for both humanity and wealth and power. And most people who are popular are somehow managed to be reasonably wealthy as well.
that we do in our culture and our society today. Well, you only have to turn on the TV, and you turn on to whatever channel you like, except the BBC, and you turn on to whatever channel you like, you might have a curtain. Now you listen to the radio, you hear advertisements. People telling you how wonderful their product is because they want to be popular. They want people to buy the product in huge numbers. I think that this is the best thing. And of course, when they're popular, they're wealthy. Oh, McDonald's. I don't know if you've ever eaten at McDonald's. I have to take the children there, or the grandchildren. I can assure you that it is an experience well worth missing. But it's hugely popular. You know, they advertise it everywhere. And then if you go to the McDonald's in Portadown, I guess that's about the nearest one there is to it. And you go there on a Saturday or any time during the Halloween half term, for that matter, if you want to go not at all, you can't get in there. It's boom. It's absolutely stuffed with people. And Ruth Croft, who was the kind of guy who found the whole concept of McDonald's and bought this little burger chain off to others, and he built it up into this huge international franchise chain, he was absolutely ruthless. All he wanted was money. And people flocking into his franchise outlets and churning out the debt. The more people, the more money, the more he smiled like a crocodile, but not spoke by the way. He got important. Yeah, he got the British Prime Minister and said he's going to use the king's stick, apparently, to kind of chain and actually draw back from it. Many of the environmental ideas that were in the government program. It was to change them and ease them and go back and, you know, be more car friendly and make it easier and more efficient to get licenses, which was the last of the North Sea gas and oil. And what do we think about this? I think it's crazy, but anyway. You know, why is he doing this? Because he thinks he's going to get new policy. He thinks this is a great idea. People will flock to the polls to vote and send it and put him back into power. He doesn't actually care much about what he's doing. He just wants to be in that office in number 10 times. What do you have to do? In power. Not quite sure what our politicians actually do. The same thing, by the way, in Northern Ireland, you get all the politicians coming around election time, stealing members through the box or knocking on the door, saying, oh, vote for me, I want to be popular, I want to be rushing. You rush to the polls and put me number one. And I'm kind of thinking, why do you bother? Because they don't seem to. They either seem to do very little most of the time, and the rest of the time they don't do anything at all. And anybody know what they're doing right now? Apart from sleeping. Jeffrey's going to go to church then. So, you know, this drive to be hugely popular, and people can even get famous for doing things. I keep coming across this name Kardashian. I'm not sure what Kardashian is. I asked my wife to be cooked with it. She Jesus' name. Well, apparently there are people who are famous for being famous. You know, I mean, you get all the coming out of social media influencers. Follow me. I get more clicks than advertising. And then I get more money. And the church can be like that as well. And we can be, oh, my goodness, there's not enough people coming. There's not enough young people coming. And then we kind of do all sorts of things to try and get it together. When I was working in Zambia, apart from what I was doing, which was teaching, I kind of also had a little parish. And I wandered around this little parish visiting people from time to time. And whenever I used to go and visit people, they had the TV on. This was urban Africa, everybody's got a TV. I said, I promise you, everybody's got a TV and everybody's got a mobile phone. And they have this TV, they have the TV on in the living room. But they couldn't, of course, afford the subscription to the satellite broadcasting system thrown out of South Africa, which was extremely expensive. And so they would have two channels on. ZNBC, which had almost anything on, and TBN, which was the sort of Trinity Broadcasting Network, which was the televangelist. And I'd go into the house, and the football, the channel, the TV would be tuned into ZNBC, and the football would be on, because Africans love their football. And they absolutely adore it. I mean, there's so many Zambian friends of mine supporting a Premier League team in England and watching the matches. I was in Burundi earlier this year and there was a football match on. I believe they're shouting in Yemen. I mean, anyway, they have this football, they have the football on, watching the football, and I'm glued to it. And I would come in and I'd sit down and really chat to them. And they turn the TV over to TBN. I don't know, go back to the football, I'd rather have the football. Although the guys at TBN were funny, except that they were serious. You know, you get these guys explaining why they needed a $60 million private jet. Oh, I'm so busy, I'm so popular. My schedule's so tight, I couldn't do it on commercial airlines. I have to fly here and there, and everybody has to kind of bow down to me, so I need my $60 million private jet. And then there'd be a little thing at the bottom of the TV screen, you know, you can ticket tape things and come across, you know, waiting for domains in Zambia, what numbers to ring to promise to domain. This guy looking for $60 million aircraft out of people who are earning $1 a day. But then I would say, something wrong here, isn't it? Greed, popularity, the drive to be better than somebody else. I mean, look, the reality is, I passed, Harry, this morning, St. John's Middleton, I passed the sign. And I never turned down it, but it's full of the 7 miles. I trusted it. Goodness knows why. I left this little lane about that wide. With grass in it, because it's home halfway along. But it's a, I said to her, I suppose she had turned off the sign. And I said, no, that's because they're going to touch it. Why do all these churches were competing with one another? I wanted to be more popular, each one wanted to be more popular than the other and get more money and build up the institution. Not quite sure how it contributes to the preaching of the gospel. They've all come to the writing to this congregation in Thessaloniki. He says that you know I suffer in Philippi. And there's all those stories in the Acts about the prison. whatever happened, that your life was too rough. Shame for the people who suffered. And then he arrives at this immediately and starts to pray with forgiveness. I came to you, he said, I was gentle. It's like a child, like a nursing mother. Should make us more like Christ and less like a turning on this 16-year-old gem. It should make us more into the image of God that we were created to be. Different. All this language about being born again, it means being a new creation. It means being the people of the God who becomes alive as if they were the God in Christ. The one who comes to us on the cross.
We stand now and declare the faith of the Church in the world in the words of the Nicene Creed on page 182.
I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible,
and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, when you have one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, for our salvation, came down from heaven, was incarnate by the Holy Spirit of the Virgin Mary, and was made man, was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. And the third day he rose again, according to the scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again, glory, to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom will have no end. And I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, and with the Father and the Son, who together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead, and life of the world to come. Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's church militant here in earth.
Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle hast taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations, and receive these our prayers which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord, and grant that all they that confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also to save and defend all Christian kings, princes, and governors, and especially thy servant Charles, our king, that under him we may be godly and quietly governed, and grant unto her whole council and to all that are put in authority under him, that they may truly and impartially minister justice to the punishment of wickedness and vice, and to the maintenance of their true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops, curates, and curate, that they may both by their life and doctrine set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacrament. And to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, especially this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succour all them who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants, departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to give us grace so to follow their good example, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for thy Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate. Amen. We stand now for our offertory hymn, which is hymn number 366. have charity with your neighbours, and intend to lead a new life along the commandments of God, walking from henceforth in his holy way, join your faith and take this holy sacrament to your family, and make your humble confession to Almighty God, meekly leaning upon your knee. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed, by thought, word, and deed, against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent, and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us. The burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. For thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, to the honour and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all them that with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sin, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear what comfortable words our Saviour Christ saith unto all that truly turn to him. Come unto me, all that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all that believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hear also what St. Paul said. This is a true saying and worthy of all to be received. Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John said. If anyone sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sin. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks unto our Lord God. It is very meet, right, and our part of duty, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, almighty and everlasting God. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim thy great, we lord and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God Almighty. Heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, Most High. We do not presume to come to this thy table, O Lord, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table. But thou art the same Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there, by his one oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, did institute and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that his precious death until his coming again.
Hear us, O merciful Father, we most humbly beseech thee, and grant that we, receiving these thy creatures of bread and wine, may be partakers, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood, who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, drink ye all of this. For this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me.
Thank you. Thank you.
In remembrance of me. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. O Lord, our Heavenly Father, we, thy humble servants, entirely desire thy fatherly goodness, mercifully to accept this our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. By humbly beseeching thee to grant that, by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and lively sacrifice unto thee,
humbly beseeching thee that all we who are partakers of this holy communion may be fulfilled with thy grace and heavenly benediction. And although we be unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offences, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom, with whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end. Amen. And we stand. Glory be to God on high.
Glory be to God on high.
And in earth peace, goodwill towards men. We praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee. We give thanks to thee for thy great glory. O Lord God, heavenly King, God the Father Almighty. O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ. O Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. Thou that sittest at the right hand of God the Father, have mercy upon us. For thou only art holy, thou only art the Lord, thou only art Christ with the Holy Spirit, art most high in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
And we sing now hymn number 92. The Son and the Holy Spirit, be with you and remain with you all.